Our beautiful native magpies, they always wake us up with cute morning calls, don't they? But some new research has found that magpies and humans are very similar when it comes to sleep. The study found that, like humans, magpies also require a good night's sleep. We are joined now by our favourite, one of our... Oh, she's the best, isn't she? Wildlife archaeologist and author, Dr. Grainne Cleary. How are you, Grainne?
Good morning to you. I'm grand, and this is just the best story. So the thing is that we keep magpies awake at night. When you're coming out of the club on King Street at 3 a.m. and you're singing and you're dancing, you're waking up your magpies. And the next morning, they're really grouchy and they can't perform as well as they could if they had a full night's sleep. And they also sing less complicated. They sing these boring, straight songs. We don't have the trill. We don't have the inundation in the songs. It's just these boring songs. And it goes to show magpies need a good night's sleep. And since they're living in urban areas, a lot of things we do can disturb them, such as lights in the area, lights that are left on all night, will actually keep magpies awake. And the next morning, they want a lion. So they'll miss their morning call, they'll miss their morning song to have a good old snooze, and will then start performing later in the day, such as 11, 12 o'clock in the day after their little sleep. Isn't that just magic?
Grainne, I love that you've just flipped this totally on its head, because magpies get such a bad rap. And we're sometimes afraid of magpies at certain times of the year. But to know that we are the ones disturbing them by coming home at 3 a.m.
Yeah.
And
they don't... Go on.
I was just going to say, what about the song they sing when they eventually do wake up? And what sorts of, how can we help them sing their song?
I don't like Mondays. That's what they...
They don't like Mondays. So part of the thing we have to do is allow for them in urban areas. So to move away from those bright white lights that we have on at night, those are the kind of lights that keep them awake. And they also, if we change them to softer lights, such as yellow lights, the magpies will actually get a better sleep. But I think this is hilarious, because if you think about a magpie during swooping season, he's got to look after the missus, keep her safe. You're out at 3 a.m. on King Street going, how are you? This is great. I'm having me buzz on. And you're waking up the magpie. The next morning, he's got to look after his territory. He sees you doing your walk of shame around the park. And he's like, that's the one that woke me up. Swoop, swoop, get out of me territory. So it does actually affect their cognitive thoughts as well. But yeah, we need to give them some space.
Well, that's it, because we knew that like they like shiny things. That's what it is. They're just sort of taking all our jewellery and then just smashing it somewhere because it's too shiny. What about their sleep? Are they like 8 hours?
Yeah, no, they like a full 10 hours. As soon as the sun goes down, they'll start gathering together and will sleep in groups or sleep in small families. But this whole thing about magpies just chasing shiny things, that's actually Tristan, the European magpie you're talking about.
Oh, yeah,
and we
like
believe
him.
That's just urban legend. Like, we don't think they actually do it.
Look, you're the expert, Grainne, so I'm going to leave it to you. But, I knew we don't like those Europeans.
Do all birds require 10 hours sleep, or is this specific to the Maggie?
All birds that are very intelligent, which most are, require the 10-hour sleep. They do require this full night's sleep, and they won't perform as good the next day, just like us, just like school kids. They need that good quality sleep.
There we go. We should start working from home.
Learn something. Sometimes when Grainne, sometimes when we see a magpie sing, they're often singing with other birds.
Yeah.
Do they kind of they perform in a choir?
They'll kind of perform in a choir themselves with their neighbours or with their own family members. And this is to mark their territory and also to reinforce bonds. So it kind of brings them all together as they sing all together. But they will often try to outcompete other birds to be the loudest bird on the block. So everybody knows this is my territory, my family lives here. So it's a way of saying this area is owned.
Oh, great. Grainne, I don't have any more questions, but I don't want to let you go either.
Yeah, tell us a little
bit about some magpies. Just tell us a little bit more about magpies, I suppose.
How can we attract magpies?
So one way, this time of the year, keep your trees, keep your native trees, and allow them to nest in the area and make friends with them. Start talking to them. Go, how are you, Mr. Magpie? They will look at you and they will talk back to you. As you found out, these birds are highly intelligent and they often, you know, are watching you as you go about your business. So once swooping season comes in, you know, give them a bit more of a break. It's only that short period. And she'll be back on to talk to you at swooping season all about your magpies.
And we love it. I can't wait till then. We appreciate all your knowledge as always. Thanks so much, Grainne. Have a great day.